This is Gene Key, Skyserve News. A former Major League Baseball player is killed in a murder-suicide in Pearland. KHOU.com reports from Pearland. Police have confirmed that former MLB player Daryl Quinn Hamilton was killed in a murder-suicide in Pearland over the weekend. Hamilton, 50, and his 44-year-old girlfriend Monica Jordan were found dead Sunday afternoon in their Pearland home. Based on the initial investigation, police said Hamilton was shot several times and Jordan died from a self-inflicted gunshot wound. Police still have a lot of questions about what led up to the incident. Police responded after getting a call just before 5 p.m. Sunday from someone who outside the home who told them there was an argument happening inside. When officers got there minutes later, they found the two bodies. Officers also found a 14-month-old child unharmed. Police said the infant is believed to be the child of Hamilton and Jordan. Texas nursing homes are facing a three-strikes-and-you're-out law, KVUE.com reports from Austin. Bad nursing homes in Texas will soon face stricter consequences from the state. Monday, Governor Greg Abbott signed SB 304, known as the three-strikes rule, into law. Starting September 2016, any nursing home cited three times for the worst offenses in a two-year span can now be shut down by the state. A man was shot after breaking down on a South Houston freeway. KHOU.com reports from Houston. Houston police said a man was shot after his car became disabled along the South Freeway on Monday evening. Houston Police Department said about 10:30 p.m. the man called 911 to report that he was shot. Officers arrived and found the man had two gunshot wounds. He was taken to the hospital in stable condition. The man told officers he broke down and then someone he knew pulled up next to him. The two got into a fight and the gunman opened fire. The suspect fled the scene and no arrests were made at the time of the shooting. Police continue their search for the suspect. The victim is expected to survive. University of Texas students want the Jefferson Davis statue removed from campus. KVUE.com reports from Austin. Hundreds of University of Texas students have signed a petition calling for the university to remove a statue of Jefferson Davis. Davis was the president of the Confederate States of America during the Civil War, and students say his support of the institution of slavery and white supremacy do not reflect the values of the university. For decades, it has sat at the foot of the iconic UT Tower facing the south. The opposition of the statue removal argued that removal of the statue is attempting to erase or rewrite history, and the statue should be kept up for historic purposes so that we can understand our past. By 10 p.m. Monday, the petition had more than 1,800 supporters. This is Gene Key, Skyserve News.